Catch22 is a charity and a social business. Our 1,500 staff working across the country are driven by the Catch22 belief that everyone can thrive if they have what we call the three P's. A purpose in life, a place to live, and good people around them. All children are vulnerable, as they are reliant on being cared for. But not all children will be exposed to risk which preys on their vulnerability. Currently, too much focus is placed on the child and not enough on the risks or the trauma that a child might face. Extra familial risk is always present, online, in a peer group, at school, in the community. But the most dangerous combination is familial risk, such as domestic abuse, impaired child development, substance abuse or criminal involvement of family members, which in turn makes a child most likely to be susceptible to external risk factors. This makes them far more likely to be at risk of poor outcomes, substance misuse themselves, offending behaviours, joblessness, or being groomed into exploitation or having violent relationships. So if we start from the premise that every child is vulnerable, a recognition of risk factors as well as trauma, and prevention and early intervention is vital. Statutory public services sometimes have difficulty engaging children and their families because of the badge, and the perception they do not trust the parent or guardian to safeguard effectively. The voluntary sector is much more likely to be able to engage and understand what is happening with that family and child's life. They are often far more embedded in the community and able to take the time to build whole family, strong and trusting relationships. This is also why there is a huge value in peer mentoring programs and schemes which encourage families to engage. Genuine collaboration is made difficult by procurement services and commissioning arrangements. The most effective public services are the ones that are truly integrated and use a trauma-informed approach. They are based on a combination of the community knowledge, skills and experience of voluntary sector organisations with the expertise of local authorities. The partnership is one of trust. At Catch22, we've experienced this firsthand. There is often an assumption that the voluntary sector know the community well, but the expertise of our practitioners can go unrecognised. For example, in our Pan Merseyside Child Exploitation and Missing Service, our service manager is a fully integrated member of the local Safeguarding Children's Partnership. This is regularly held up as a best practice example of voluntary sector and local authority partnerships working. The government should also consider the impact of volunteers in the delivery of statutory services. There are some brilliant examples of how much of an impact volunteers can have in creating a truly place-based approach because of the value they bring to the community identity through language, culture, or simply knowledge of local people. To be most effective, volunteer management needs to be built into commissioning contracts. It's well known that there is too little focus on prevention and early intervention. This is partly because it is extremely difficult to evidence what has been prevented, but also because resources are limited and are inevitably used on crisis intervention, as it is impossible to cut this. We are sometimes frustrated that we are commissioned to intervene only when issues have already occurred. Difficulties also arise when multiple services are involved with one family or child. Having one trusted point of contact who can refer to other agencies is proven to be most effective. In 2016, the Department for Education's Innovation Unit commissioned Catch22 to deliver a successful service model on this approach, called Fact22. There are too few culturally sensitive services, meaning that there are communities within the UK who can't access support offered or find it conflicts with certain cultural traditions and practices, or where language is a barrier. We need a long-term strategy which tackles the underlying, deeply embedded issues. What we're currently seeing is a trends-based approach, which attempts to tackle one major issue at a time, such as county lines. It isn't policies or protocols or paperwork to keep a child safe, it's people. A child is vulnerable when they are isolated for whatever reason. A child with other people standing alongside is protected.
Catch22 delivers quality alternative provision education across 12 schools that focuses on building trusted relationships and reintegration into mainstream settings, or transition onto further education or employment. All our learners achieve positive outcomes, thrive, and enjoy a quality education. And that education is delivered by skilled, passionate people with high expectations in a place that is safe and appropriate. By intervening early, there is a greater chance of preventing many of the risk factors which prey on childhood vulnerability.
Ripples is part of Catch22 and delivers the PAWSE service across Derbyshire. PAWSE works successfully with women who have experienced or are at risk of repeat pregnancies which result in children needing to be removed from their care. Through our work, we aim to reduce the number of children being taken into care. PAWSE works together with local authorities and other agencies. The service aims to break transgenerational cycles and support vulnerable women to develop a sense of self-worth with significant improvements to substance abuse, domestic violence and mental health, as well as improving contact with children and gaining access to services.
Catch22 works to deliver a truly collaborative risk and resilience early intervention model. Our experience tells us that where child exploitation and missing from home services are commissioned together, they are more effective at identifying and managing risk as well as being more economically viable. We work with a range of partner agencies, including the police and children's social care, to reduce the risk of child exploitation and prevent further missing episodes. We have services based within multi-agency safeguarding hubs to respond quickly to children's needs and work in a truly integrated way. Our key workers build holistic and trusting relationships through individual and therapeutic support, group activities and signposting to other services. We work successfully across Merseyside, the West Midlands, Merton, Stoke and Staffordshire and Derbyshire, helping some of the most vulnerable children to get their lives back on track.
The online world presents huge opportunities for finding purpose, connection and community, which is why tackling digital exclusion is an important part of Catch22's work in terms of both digital skills and access. We know that digital connectivity is essential for our lives and it must be seen as a right and not a luxury for all. But the online world also presents significant risks. It is a fast-moving space and the risks of online grooming and exposure to violence and trauma for children and young people are rapidly growing. At Catch22, we are conducting in-depth academic research on the harms we know are experienced online by young people, especially the most vulnerable, and what can be done to effectively tackle these issues. This research will be published in April 2021. Our combined approach will help children and young people to be protected from risk and to thrive in an increasingly digital world.
Vulnerable children and young people need genuine alternatives to change the direction of their lives. We deliver a preventative, future-thinking approach for children and young people who are marginalised and at risk, focusing on education, employability and peer support. We address the basic skills needs of young people disengaged from education and employment, from CV writing to interview techniques, and have programmes specifically focused on particular areas, such as digital skills. We know how important trusted relationships are and therefore make sure all candidates have a trusted employment coach to support them. We also support the businesses themselves when they take on our candidates to make sure there are positive outcomes on both sides. Our programmes are proven to help people progress into apprenticeships, traineeships, or other employment, whatever their barriers might be.